In this example, we are given that the figure shows a fixed solid sphere of mass m and radius r with a narrow smooth tunnel along its diameter, we can see here. And another particle of mass m is placed at the point A at a distance 2r from its center along the line of tunnel, as we can see. And if the particle is released from rest, obviously due to attraction of m, it will start moving towards the sphere, and we are required to find its speed when it reaches the center of a sphere. So here in this situation, we can directly use energy conservation or work energy theorem, as we have studied in dynamics, that in various problem, whenever we are required to calculate the speed of a particle in its motion, it is advisable to use energy conservation. So as particle is moving from point A to C, first let us calculate gravitational potential at A is Va. Due to sphere potential at A, as it is the outer point, we can write Va is minus gm by 2r. And in this situation, if we wish to find potential at point C, which is the center where particle is finally reaching, it can be written as at center, we know it is 3 by 2 times that of the surface, so it is minus 3 by 2 gm by r. And as particle is moving from A to C, then using conservation of energy for motion of m from A to C, we have, here you can write at point A it was having potential energy as mva only, and as it was released from rest, no kinetic energy was there. When it will reach C, say it is having a speed v, then the same energy must be held at point C. So it will be mvc is the potential energy plus some kinetic energy, half mvc square. Vc is the speed at point C. Then this kinetic energy will be there in the particle. So here m gets cancelled out, and directly we can write the speed of particle at center is a root of twice Va minus Vc. If we substitute the value of Va Vc from here, you can see we are getting it as root of twice of minus gm by r plus 3 by 2 gm by r. And on solving the expression, finally we'll be getting the result to be root of this, you can see 3 by 2 gm by r minus gm by r will be gm by 2r. So it is gm by r. So finally the result we are getting is 2 gm by r. That will be the answer to this question, that is the speed in the particle when it is crossing the point C.